How can drones be used in construction? I'm super excited about this because there are independent drone takeoff stations. There are really, really nice drones that you can get for a really, really reasonable price. It expands our ability to do work in construction. So I'm going to go through a list of possible uses to really like spark your interest so you can dig in. And if you ever want help, we have a complete VDC, we call it a VDC pod, but it's essentially its own functional group or department that can help you with this if you ever want to implement it. But this is exciting, exciting, exciting stuff. So if you've come for that, stay with us. All right, so drones are becoming very popular in construction. And throughout the world, actually, we see drones in warfare, which I'm not super happy about the warfare, but we see drones in warfare, we see drones with delivery, we see drones with firefighting, we see drones with like freeway and tree maintenance, we see drones with video footage, we see drones with entertainment. I mean, we're seeing drones everywhere. It's not going to be long before we have delivery service, taxis, transportation, all using drones. We have drones for our company that we use for video footage, for inspections. It's quite fantastic. And actually, I was thinking the other day, like, how cool would it be for a drone to just take off and check the status of a construction project? And I found out they have automatic takeoff pads with timers, with pre-recorded, predetermined routes where drones actually do that very thing, either with a 360 camera or simply with images. But having real-time data is absolutely huge. So let's head into this world. Let's get creative. Let me start out by telling you just a sketchy bit of a story, though. When I read the book, it was recommended to me by Peter Berg, I think, at DPR. Absolutely fantastic book. It's called Building the Empire State. I remember a specific part in there where the superintendent for the project, and this was a massively successful project, in today's dollars, about $147 million under budget 2 weeks early. Successful project, massively successful project. The superintendent had runners. These runners would go find out production information, pass along information, send messages. Today's equivalent of that is probably lead persons, communication tools, communication channels, field engineers. But how cool would it be if drones became a runner or a help to the superintendent from a mobile command station? I think it would be super cool. So let me give you some ideas right now, without further ado, that will hopefully spark your interest in implementing and using drones on your construction project. Number one, site surveys and mapping. And this is happening right now. Not only can your drones give you really good aerial footage and video, your drones can also map the 3D topography throughout the project site within a really, like, relatively useful accuracy. It's really, really quite nice. This helps in a number of different ways. Not only does it help with logistics, it helps with integration in the model, it helps with real-time data to help the superintendents and the foreman lead the project, but it also helps us with material takeoffs. It can track production. Absolutely fantastic. This is being used today. Number two, progress monitoring. Let's consider this. Let's say you have your afternoon foreman huddles like you're supposed to be having, and I mean that positively, where you and the foreman look at the status of the project, and then you plan the next day and recover any delays or make up for any variation and really keep everything stable. How cool would it be if your drone literally took off and did an overall capture of the entire site and safely, I don't know that we're there yet entirely, but safely was able to go through the actual building itself and you were able to, in the meetings, recall the actual footage. Even if we're not ready for drones to go inside yet, which I think one day we will be able to, we are definitely able to do it from an overall site, overall perspective, and we could have massive amounts of data for these planning meetings so we know exactly where we are. I mean, this is super cool. Three, inspections and quality control. This is something that's already happening. In fact, I remember one time for a med gas inspection, we had to build the two sides of a chase. We had med gas going up, but we had to inspect all the fittings like, you know, we typically do. And there were a couple of hard to reach areas. And instead of ripping down the whole assembly, we were using GoPros with the iPad and doing these tests. The inspector was very kind to us, right? And so that was like the first time I used it, and it was just for a GoPro. What if drones could now do this work? What if drones could now go up on the exterior and really, really inspect? Do you remember, because I do, the days when you had to go get a harness, had to go get on the boom lift, where's the key? How do you start this thing? You know, do you have the certification to get on it, right? And to go up and QC it, and the amount of time that it took to do that really prevented us from getting it done. So you had to rely on like the field verifieds, and I love field verified, but the field verifieds of the world where they came and did the inspections and we had very little internal. Could you imagine right now actually having drones and being able to see not only the progress of the exterior and the roof and hard to reach areas safely, obviously, you know, because you don't want the drone falling on somebody. So you would have to create a controlled access zone, but to be able to inspect those hard to reach areas, I think it's fantastic, and it would pair perfectly with the official testing and inspections that you do. Number four, safety management. Yes, I believe in going to the Gemba, being in the at the place of work, but how cool would it be for drones to go out and do quick double checks? You could even do it for PTPs. You could inspect high-risk areas that aren't easily seen. Make sure people are wearing their fall protection. This is not a police state thing. This is a, we're gonna back people up. And you could also do an inspection in the morning, like maybe not for scaffolding, because for scaffolding, you probably gotta be pretty close, but you could inspect handrail, you could inspect tow boards, you could inspect netting. There's a lot of different things that you could use drones for safety and health. Another one that I really like is the progress photos and the historical documentation. So, you know, how we do daily reports, right, with a few pictures and a few notes, but how impactful would it be if we had drone footage every single day? It would literally tell the story and document on video what's happening every day, day to day on site. And these are just a few of the things that I would recommend. But let me just go ahead and tell you what I did and just some of the small steps that we're taking in our company. So we have some drones. We use them for aerial photos, for aerial video. We do use it for the topographic mapping. We do use it for the afternoon foreman huddles, which I highly recommend, where you have the real-time data. We do use it for documentation, and we have started using it for the inspections and reaching those hard-to-see areas and for safety compliance, and it's absolutely fantastic. Let me accentuate this just a little bit by saying the area superintendent will be in the field quite a bit. I still don't know what would be wrong if an assistant superintendent was out there at his or her little desk with the canopy, like I used to see Brent Elliott do at the Bioscience Research Laboratory. And if there's a specific area that needed to be inspected, go ahead and put your drone down, find your company's specific safety rules when it comes to drones, and go ahead and monitor the job, put it back in the case, do your field walks, and use it as a balance. For a project superintendent will spend half the time in the office, half the time in the field. A drone could be an amazing supplement for that. So here's what I would recommend. Get with your techie people in your company, go through and identify a model, make your first purchase, and make the assignment. Hey, let's start finding valuable uses for these things. And then from project to project, you'll find another, and then another, and then another. And you'll find yourself on the cutting edge of this and being able to use it for things that really are a game changer on site. One of the biggest ones for me is the videos, the real-time videos and photographic documentation every day in your foreman huddles. This is going to be a game changer. So I'm going to give you a list of these options in a Canva graphic in the description below, and reach out to us if you ever need help. We have a fully trained team that knows at least the starting applications for this. We can help you. I hope you've enjoyed this video. On we go.